Hello everyone, this is Jyoti Mishra from My Clothing Treasure, and today I have a tassar sari, a desi tassar sari for you, which has ikat border and ikat pallu. So let's go through the sari and all the details. So as you can see, the color is that of pure tassar that hasn't been dyed in any color. So this is the original color of tassar. And as you can see, the weaving and the texture, it has a lot of texture. These tassar sarees have a lot of texture, and the way the weaving is done, there is a lot of gap, you can see, and it's very porous and airy, because of which it allows air to move inside. And it's where, you know, if you touch it, it will feel a little cooler in comparison to the mulberry silk. Mulberry silk is the silk that we mostly use in our pure silk sarees, like Kanjivaram, Banarasi, Ikat Pochampalli, all that. So the this tassar sarees, they feel a little cooler in comparison, and that's why they are very fit for warmer weathers and for summers. And one interesting fact is that the ikat border that you see here, even though the sari is entirely woven in Chhattisgarh by the Chhattisgarh weavers, this border that you see, they don't actually have the knowledge how to do this ikat kind of things. So this ikat, they source their ikat tied and dyed threads from Odisha. In Odisha, the Sambalpuri Bandhakada is very popular, and it's a part of the western belt of Odisha where they practice this type of ikat. So what they do is they first tie the threads in different parts depending upon the pattern they want to make, and then to make this flower, what they will do is first they will have to tie the threads here, okay, where they tie the thread, the color doesn't get inside into that part. So if they want some part to remain colorless, they have to tie that part, and otherwise this part has to be dyed in this color. Then there is a tie part, then there is this maroonish red, then again the tie, and again this color, then again a tie. So they have to decide how the pattern will come out before, and then they have to tie accordingly. So it's a very tedious task, and that's the reason the Odisha ikat sarees are so expensive, because it requires a lot of effort and calculation. So they kind of place the threads together, see if the pattern is coming right. After that, they start weaving. So these Chhattisgarh weavers, they are not very aware of this thing. They are not experts in doing this ikat thing. So they source their threads from Odisha. The threads are already tied and dyed according to a pattern, and then they just weave it. So this part is made like that. And you can also see the temple border. It's entirely woven, and this is the blouse piece in contrast, matching the border. It also comes with the same ikat border, and then comes this pallu. The pallu has also the same ikat pattern. This is a beautiful these patterns, they look very nice together, though, you know, the sari is pure tassar color. With that, this contrast works beautifully. And I have few more colors in these. I will share one by one. I hope you like this one.